High glory to God. Have you ever asked yourself, how am I supposed to make my day great? I'm going to show you just that this morning. And my name is Pastor Peter Asiazobor, bringing God's word to you. Hallelujah. So this morning, I'm going to read from Hebrews chapter number 5. And I'll be taking verse 13 and 14. And it reads, it says, for everyone that useth milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. But strong meat belongeth to them that are of full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. Hallelujah. This is really awesome. Awesome scriptures declaring and showing to us the path that we must follow in this new year. It's a new season. The Lord spoke to us. It's our season of unlimited grace. Hallelujah. Just yesterday, a brother wrote me a text and told me how that the Lord granted his heart desires and he's gotten his papers, and it was exciting to him. So he decided to share it with me and with the church of God. Hallelujah. So we're starting off the year in a good note. The Lord is doing great things already. Yes. And the next person on the line is you for a miracle. Hallelujah. But a way to go, there's a way to tap into this miraculous, into the realms of the miraculous, into this realm of unlimited grace. There is a way to operate. Yes, it takes those who are skilled in the word of righteousness, those who know exactly how to handle the things of the spirit, those who know exactly how to take advantage of the grace of God. And you say, Pastor, it's like naturally I'm not gifted in all that, in the things of the spirit. No, it's come by training. You train yourself in the things of the spirit. And that's why this scripture is letting us know the way to go. In verse 13 of Hebrews 5, it says, for everyone that useth milk is unskillful in the words of righteousness. You know, when we get born, when we got born even in the natural, we grew up gradually. We grew up, we were given milk as babes because that's what we could handle at that stage of our life. But a certain time comes that we are expected to outgrow the use of milk. We are supposed to outgrow that stage and then get into a stage where we can take solid food. Yes, because solid food will make us grow bigger, grow stronger, and it's what we need also at that stage of being, much more grown. Yes, in the same thing applies in the realms of the spirit. There's a time you can be a babe in the things of the spirit. There's a time you are allowed to, be a bit not so much operating in much wisdom, if I may put it that way. But there's a time the Lord expects you to outgrow the foolish things of the earth, or that babes do, and to get into maturity. But this comes as you continue to feed yourself in God's word. So he said, for everyone that useth milk is unskillful. Those who still get the things, the milk of the world, those who are going after messages maybe that makes them feel good, the feel good kind of message always. Yes, of course, the word of God makes us feel good, but sometimes we may be instructed in the ways of righteousness that may not be too good to our flesh, but we take it anyhow because we know it's what is needed for our growth. Yes, for our spiritual development. Hallelujah. So when you are able to take those messages, those instruction of the spirit that is good for your health spiritually, even though it may not make your flesh feel good, then you are good to go. Hallelujah. He said, those who consistently use milk, they are unskillful in the word of righteousness. So it means we need to be skilled in the word of righteousness. The ability to use the word, to put the word to work and see it produce results in our lives. And that's the way to go in this year of unlimited grace. Yes, the abilities of the spirit. to be able to put the word of God to work in our life, to be able to put the word of God to work in your job, to be able to put the word of God to work in your business, to be able to put the word of God to work in your academic, to be able to put the word of God to work in your family, in your marriage. Yes, the abilities of the Spirit, to be able to put the word of God to work in your ministry, the ability of the Spirit, to be able to put the word of God to work in your head, and the abilities to be able to put the word of God to work even in your finances. That's what brings the change. Exactly. The ability to walk the word of God, because the word of God has in itself the ability to bring to pass what it talks about. Yes, the abilities of God, the power of God is conveyed through his words. Yeah, through words the world was created. Yes, through word God conveys his power. The Bible says he sent forth his word, and his word healed them and delivered them from all their destruction. It's always through words. Just check out most of the miracles that were done in scriptures. They were done through words. The giving of the word. Hallelujah. Jesus said to that man, he said, go wash in the pool. Go wash your face in the pool. He gave the word. Yes, you know, it always comes through words. So the ability for you to handle the word of righteousness, that's what determines your attitude in life. Hallelujah. And this scripture says, when we are still babes, we are still unskillful. When we are still going after the base things of the word of God, we are still unskillful. But then he said, but strong meat belong to them who that are of full age. Strong meat belong to them that are of full age. Not full age in terms of physical age. No, it's a full age in the things of the Spirit. Full age in maturity of the Spirit. Yeah, full age. Strong meat belong to them, which means strong meat of the word. The strong things of the word, the principles of God's word that are strong, that, you know, that you take anyhow, even though your flesh is crying no, even though your flesh is shouting no, but you know that this is the instruction of the Spirit to you, and you stick to it. The ability to discipline your spirit, the ability to discipline your soul, the ability to discipline your mind, the ability to discipline your flesh, and say, no, I'm going to walk the word, I'm going to obey the word, I'm going to put the word of God to work. It's raining, I'm going to church. It's raining, I'm not going to sit at home. Yes, the weather don't seems convenient, but there's a meeting to attend. Yes, I'm going there. I'm going to put myself anyhow, even in the rain. I'm going to go through the weather, because I know going to the house of God, I get so much. I receive so much that I don't want to miss. You see, once you come to this stage of development, where you're able to put the word of God to work based on the fact that you know certain things of the Spirit, you begin to operate above that level of the base. And that's when you are set to receive and to see unlimited grace at work in your life and in your situation. It's a strong meat. Strong meat. They belong to those who, through reason of use. Take note of this. He said, those who, by reason of use, have their senses exercised. You see, the word of God is meant for our use. We walk the word. We are word practitioners. Yes, the word of God is meant to be put to use in our lives. Until you walk the word, you don't get results. And so many people, that's where they miss it. They expect the word to just produce without them putting out themselves for the word. You walk the word. You act the word. When Jesus gave the word to that man, he said, go wash your eyes in the pool. That man had to step on the word. That man had to act on the word. You see, it's not enough to receive the word, but it's important to act on the word. When Jesus was walking on waters, getting towards the boat, and the disciples were in the boat, and Peter saw Jesus, he said, if it is you, Lord, give me the word. Just say the word. Ask me to come. You know, Peter understood that if it were the Lord, and if he gives the word, that he could walk on waters based not on his own abilities, based not on and the knowledge that he had, prior knowledge of how to walk on waters before, but based on the word that he was going to walk on waters. And he said, just ask me to come. If it is indeed you, Lord. And Jesus gave the word to Peter and he said, come. And Peter stepped out of the boat. Peter stepped out of the boat, not based on any other thing, but based on the word. You see, your faith only acts based on God's word. Your faith does not act based on your feeling. Your faith does not act, does not produce results based on your what you want. You know, some people just want things and then they think they act by faith. No, your faith must be founded on God's word. If it's not founded on the word, it can't work. So once you locate any privilege, any of God's promises in his word, you know that this promise is based on the word. You can act on the word. You can act on the word and expect a miracle. And the word always produces, because the word has in itself the ability to bring to pass what it talks about. And I see this day, I see as you get out, as you set out today, as you go out into the day, as you go out concerning your business, concerning your job, concerning your academics, as you do what you do for the glory of our God, I see miracles happening because you're walking on the word, you acting on the word. Yes, he said, those who by reason of use, you need to put the word of God to use. It's not enough to talk the word, it's not enough to think the word, it's not enough to just, you know, read the word. It's important to put the word of God to use. He said, these are certain persons who by reason of use, they have their senses exercised. Yes, we have our spiritual senses that must be exercised. Just like when people go for the academics pursuit in school or whatever, you know, they had to go through tests in class, they had to take exams, they had to study, and all this, they take tests and they exercise themselves. Why? They are exercising their mind. They are exercising their mind. So by the time they are gone out of school, after going through this many exercises, then they are set for the profession that of their choice. Exactly. In the same vein, in the realms of the spirit, you can't be matured. You can't get to that stage of maturity where you are able to lord it over the devil and his agents until you have gotten your spiritual senses exercised in the word. So put out yourself daily. As you wake up this morning, you don't jump out and jump into the street like the natural man. Like I said yesterday, you don't jump out of the bed like the natural man and jumps into the street. And that's why many of them jump into trouble. They jump into destruction. They jump into, you know, things that they never bargain for. But that's not your story. That's not so for you, because you are a child of God. Whenever you wake up in the morning, you dedicate your time to thank the Lord, to exhort him for what he has done for you, for the life he's giving you. You take time to study his word. And as you study the word, revelation is given to your spirit. Then you pray. As you pray in the spirit, your eyes are open. You begin to chart your day. You begin to rearrange your day. You begin to set things aright. Those things that the enemy must have planted your way to cause you harm, you take them off the way. You prearrange your days in prayers, so that by the time you hit the street, by the time you step out, yes, all sort of devils that were in the street, they will see themselves fleeing in every direction. Why? Because they see a giant in you, a giant coming, a giant coming. You may look small, you may not look big, but when they look through, they are seeing a giant in you, a giant in God's word, because God's word has you so much soaked the word of God in. And now you are ready to go, ready to take on the forces of the world, ready to take on spiritual wickedness in high and low places. And when you step into a room, they see themselves fleeing, darkness fleeing every direction. Why? Because you carry in the light of God into that atmosphere. You bring in the atmosphere of heaven wherever you go. Why? Because you soak yourself in the world. You've had your spiritual senses exercised. Hallelujah. That's the way to go this year. That's the way to go in 2021. And when you go this way, when the word will be saying there's a cast down, your son will be there's a lifting up, and they'll be wondering. You'll be like the children of Israel who carry their own atmosphere into the wilderness, into the desert place, so that even though the things were not working out in the desert, but because they carry their own atmosphere, because they brought their own atmosphere with them, the Bible said in the day God was unto them like a pillar of cloud, protecting them from the heat of the sun. And in the night, God was unto them like a pillar of fire. Yes, they carried their own atmosphere. That's what you need this year. That's what you need today as you go out. You carry the atmosphere of heaven. So that it doesn't matter what the economy is like. It doesn't matter what the government is saying. It doesn't matter what the pandemics that are out there. Before you step out of your house, you have taken time to pray. You've taken time to mingle with the Spirit, to mingle with heaven, to mingle with His word. And by reason of use, you've had your spiritual senses exercised, so that by the time you step out, you are carrying the atmosphere of heaven. Yes, you're carrying favor with you. You're carrying God's presence with you. And things just had to fall into place, because you come not in your name. You come in the name of Him that sent you. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody say, wow, Pastor, what words, what glorious words. I really love this, but I'm not a Christian. I'm not a child of God, and I want to be one today. Yes, you can be. You can be today. The Bible said, with the heart man believe, but with the mouth, confession, declaration, announcement is made unto salvation. The scripture declares that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And you can call upon the name of the Lord today. You can be that whosoever. Yes. So you could repeat this prayer after me, meaning it from your heart, and the Lord will make you His own. Hallelujah. So you just repeat this prayer with me. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus. Yes, repeat that after me. You say, I come to you just as I am, a sinner, but I've heard your word, and I believe that you send your son Jesus Christ to die for me as the perfect sacrifice for my sin. Today I believe and I receive Jesus as the Lord of my life, and from this day onward He is the Lord and Savior of my life. And if you made that prayer according to scriptures, you are born again. In heaven right now there's a party, all because of you. Yes, there's a party, joy in heaven. I want to admonish you to look out for a Bible-believing church in the city where you live. Yes, join that church so that you'll be groomed up and trained in the things of God. Exactly. So you'll be trained in the things of God. And if peradventure you live anywhere in Italy, anywhere around Padova in Italy, maybe in any of the adjoining cities like Ferrara, Rovigo, Bologna, Vicenza, Mestre, Venice, Treviso, I want to invite you specially to worship with us at Healing Grace Christian Assembly, Via J Avanzo, number 17 is the number, just behind the Padova train station. As soon as you come out from the underground tunnel in the Acela direction, you find a building where you find the polizia locale. We are just beside. You find a yellow doorpost. You walk right in, and we are there at the first floor. On Sundays, we have our Sunday school starting by 10 o'clock, and by 11 o'clock, our main service starts. Yes. And on Tuesdays, we have our prayer meetings. Yes, time to pray for your prayer needs, where you can come around and be blessed. Like today, this evening, we'll be there by 6:30, between 6:30 and 8 p.m. Yeah, and we'll be expecting you with open hands. We want to pray with you. We want to help you grow in the things of the Spirit and receive all that God has in stock for you. Exactly. And I want you to do something special this morning. Exactly. Help somebody start a good day. Help somebody make their day great by sharing this message with at least 10 persons in your contact, with at least 10 of your friends. Share this message with them, especially your loved ones. Let them have this message so that they too can start up their day great. Exactly. And also, if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, the name is Pastor Peter Asiazobor on YouTube, and you subscribe to our YouTube channel. We have a whole lot of messages, a whole lot of resources that will bless you and increase you in the things of the Spirit. Exactly. So subscribe on that channel, and you can have access to all these resources that will bless you. And ensure to turn on the notification bell so that anytime we post new videos or audios, like we always do every day, it will be a blessing to you. You'll be one of the first to receive it. Exactly. So ensure to subscribe on YouTube, on our YouTube channel, Pastor Peter Asiazobor, and you'll be blessed. So I want to wish you have a great day. God bless you.